Good morning, students. Today we will start our next point. See, yesterday we started a physical and chemical change lesson. Okay, we have discussed about the physical change and examples. What is exactly a physical change? And maybe you have written some examples of physical changes. So now today we will see the next point, that is a chemical change. Now chemical change, in the physical change, the change occurs in state, shape, okay, means this all the physical properties. But in chemical change, here the new substance is formed. Okay, the chemical reaction is occur in this chemical change. So what is the exactly definition of chemical change? See, a change in which new substances with entirely different chemical composition and properties from the original substance are formed is called chemical change. Means here what happens? See, a new substance is formed and totally means entirely it is a different from the original substance. See, in the physical change there is no new substance is a form, and whatever the only the state, maybe color, maybe shape, size will change, but not totally whole properties of that substance will change. But in a chemical change, here entirely whole original substance is changed and a new substance is formed. See, a change in which new substance with entirely different chemical compositions means all the characteristics are different from its original substance. This change is known as a chemical change, and chemical changes are irreversible change. Means in this change, if any time the chemical reactions occur, the original substance will not get back. It is not a reversible, it is a irreversible change. Now for example, cooking of food. Okay, when your mother is preparing food, that time what? Totally a different new substance is formed. Means the raw rice, you will get the raw rice again. No, why? Because totally entire all the characteristics change when the boiled rice we will get. Okay, means here the new substance we are getting. Then growing plants change. Then rusting of iron. Now, rusting of iron means what? Here the new substance is formed. When iron is come contact with air and water. See, now rust means what? If it is iron substance, see this one is an iron nail. Okay, now it is a new iron nail. After some times, means if you will keep this like this only, then this iron is a metal. Okay, when this iron will come contact with air and water. See, now in our surrounding, in this season, the rainy season, moisture is present. It means water vapors are here in our surrounding. So because of the moisture, it will react with this iron. And here one brown color layer you will see after some times, maybe after 1 month. Okay, brown color layer. So here what? The new substance is formed. Okay, so this is a chemical change. So for that only, to prevent the rusting, what we are painting, that all oil paint we are using. Why? Because to prevent from rusting. Okay, so chemical changes means what? Totally a new substance is formed, and whatever the original substance, the desired characteristics are change. Okay, in your textbook one activity it is given. See, in that what, how the chemical change occurs, that it is shown. So for that, which things we needed? See, here in this petri dish, or here the blue color one chemical product it is given. Okay, this is known as a CuSO4. Now CuSO4 means what? Copper sulfate. Okay, what is the name of this copper sulfate? Just open your textbook. In that activity is given, first activity. See, in the chemical change, this is a copper sulfate. Okay, and and in this beaker, this copper sulfate solution, means we use water and this powder we put in this, and now here the copper sulfate solution. Now what we have to do, in this copper sulfate solution, this iron nail we have to put it. See, iron nail. After some times, what will happen? Because it will take a time. Okay, after some times, what these copper sulfate solution, it will react with this iron nail. Okay, this copper sulfate solution will react with iron nail, and it will form the two new substance will form. That is, now see here, this color of solution is a blue, but after some times, if you will see, the color of solution is a green. Okay, because why green? Because now the next means another solution, that is iron sulfate solution, is a form. Okay, and on this nail you will see, after some time you will see here the brown color layer, and that brown color layer is known as a copper. Okay, now in this reaction, see, it will take a more time. So see, copper sulfate solution will react with this iron nail, and it form iron sulfate solution, and the copper layer is deposited on this iron nail. Okay, do you understand this activity? Read this activity properly. Now see, here I have already we done it, but it will take a more time. See, this iron and this iron, what is the difference in these two iron nail? See, this is a new one, but this is old one, and here if you will see, the brown color layer is a form. Okay, that brown color layer means what? Copper layer. Okay, so now we will see what happened in this reaction. See, I written here reaction, copper sulfate solution means this blue color solution is known as a copper sulfate. Okay, copper sulfate solution plus iron, which what we use, iron nail we use, so iron, and it will form a iron sulfate solution and copper. Now iron sulfate solution color is green. Okay, iron sulfate solution color is green, and here copper sulfate solution color is blue. So CuSO4, this is a symbolic representation. CuSO4, copper sulfate is known as, in the chemical formula, how to write this? CuSO4, the name is copper sulfate. CuSO4 plus iron means Fe. Okay, they, when they react with each other, then it will form FeSO4 plus Cu. Cu means what? Copper. This reaction you have to write down in your chemistry notebook. So here in this reaction, see, these two are the original substance. Okay? And why it is a chemical change? Because when these two they reacted with each other, it formed a new substance. See here, this one is a new substance and this is also a new substance. FeSO4 and Cu is a form. Means totally desired characteristics of this substance has changed. Okay, new substance is formed, so it is known as a chemical change. Now more examples, curding of milk. Curding of milk also chemical change. Why? Because first you see the milk, what is the taste of a milk, but when it convert into a curd, what will be the taste? Okay, and the milk, that original substance, you will get back? No. Why? Because the reaction occur in that. So it is known as a chemical change. All the characteristic totally it is different from original substance. So these type of changes are known as a chemical changes. Okay, do you understand it? See, again two times at least you see video and read lesson properly and write this all the points in your chemistry notebooks. Remaining points we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.